Hello friends, I hope you like my 11th video that is about functional risk assessment. If you are having any question, you can ask me in the comment. So in this video, we will discuss about the installation qualification for computerized system. Friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality. So please view, like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standards and practices. So in this slide, we will discuss about the installation qualification for computerized system. So installation qualification actually assures the required physical hardware and software components have been installed and configured correctly in accordance with the specifications. So for example, when you are having any instrument or equipment and that instrument or equipment will connect to some software to operate that instrument or equipment, right? So the installation and configuration of the hardware and software should be done in such a way that whatever the command we are giving from the software, that hardware take that command and execute that process for each and every individual function. So whatever the function which is available with the software and that is configured with that hardware, so whatever the command we are giving from that software, exactly the hardware will take that command and execute that process, right? So usually the software is installed in a test or validation environment to verify the correct installation and configuration of software and hardware. So now, what is the installation qualification protocol? So the installation qualification protocol verifies the proper installation and configuration of system depending on the system needs and complexity. So for the installation qualification, we need to prepare the protocol which are having the set of test scripts to verify the installation and configuration of system, right? So now the installation qualification protocol should be approved before the protocol execution. So installation qualification protocol should be approved by the quality and then only test can be performed, right? So the executed protocol should be signed by the tester. Tester means who has executed that test and reviewed by the system owner. So the system owner means the user department head. And finally, it will be approved by the quality. So now in this slide, we will discuss what should cover in the installation qualification protocol, that is called IQP. So the following test may include but not limited to. So first one is the verification of connected instrument or equipment name and ID and serial number. So for example, instrument name is SPLC or UV spectrophotometer. So we need to write. So next one is the instrument ID. So there will be the some in-house procedures available to assign the some identification number of that hardware and the serial number, which is mentioned at the hardware or manufacturer document. Second is verification of workstation configuration. So we need to verify the PC related configuration, for example host name, that is some identification number of PC, operating system, that is which window operating system is available, like you know the window 10 or other processor. We need to verify like Intel core or other processor. Next is RAM capacity and hard disk capacity we need to verify, and also the IP address of the system we need to verify. Third is verification of installed software, that is software name and its version number. Fourth is a connectivity test with server name, domain server, backup server. So there will be the ping test we need to perform to check the connectivity of client system with the system server or domain server or backup server. So such kind of things we need to include in the installation qualification protocol. Now in this slide, we will discuss about the practical approach to write an installation qualification test script. So the first test script is for the verification of system hardware and operating software details. So in the step of IQ test script, following details we need to mention for the verification, but it is not limited to, right? So first one is the verification of system host name, system IP address, system serial number, right, and system make and model. Next is verification of system processor and RAM capacity. Next is verification of network interface card, that is called Ethernet. Next is verification of USB ports, that is how many number of USB ports are available in the system. Next is verification of time zone as per the, you know, the respective country, and what is the current date and time. Next is verification of hard disk and its capacity. Next is verification of operating system name, operating system type, and operating system version number. So the next is verification of software name and software version number. Next is verification of electronic data backup path, that is where the data backup will be done. Next is verification of PDF viewer application. Next is verification of printer connectivity. And next is verification of antivirus which is installed. So the second test script for the verification of connectivity between client system and instrument, that is checking process for the connectivity between software and hardware. So we need to verify the connectivity between client system and installed instrument through USB port or LAN cable. Next, verification of ping for server connection. So in this we need to ping the command with the IP address to verify the connectivity. So now the third test script for the verification of power supply and environmental condition where the system has been installed. So first one, verification of system power supply, that is system is connected with the well established power supply. Next is verification of power supply with UPS, that is uninterrupted power supply. So if the power has gone, there should not be any impact on the running system. Next is verification of environmental condition of the installed system, that is system is installed in the controlled temperature and relative humidity environment. So friends, this is all about the installation qualification, and in the next video we will discuss about the operational qualification. I hope this video will help to better understand what is installation qualification. Thank you.